Hello engineers, today we are going to discuss about displacement thickness in boundary layer. This is the fourth video of the boundary layer video series. Now let's start the video. As we know that when object is moving through a fluid, a region of velocity variation is created on the surface of the object. That is nothing but the boundary layer, as we discussed in the previous parts. We also discussed that the boundary layer thickness, which is a distance measured from the surface to the that point of the fluid where velocity is 0.99 of u infinity. This distance is called as a boundary layer thickness. As x changes, the boundary layer thickness also going to change, right? At this point, the boundary layer thickness is this much, right? This is the del boundary layer thickness. Now friends, I want to make you clear about this curve, that what it indicates actually. Fluid is flowing over the object surface, right? This is the x. This graph shows the velocity at this particular x. To understand better, I have drawn this figure separately. This length determines the magnitude of the velocity at this point. As you can see that at the surface there is no length, so velocity is zero. As u goes above, the lengths are increasing, so magnitude of the velocity increases. Let's consider that at time t is equal to zero, particles are on this line. And when time t is equal to 1, the particles covered this distance, right? For your understanding, I am considered that at time t is equal to 0, the fluid is at this line, and after time t is equal to 1, the fluid will make curve like this, right? These all are fluid particles. This is the same here. To understand what is the displacement thickness, I am taking a very small portion of thickness dy. The bigger version of this fluid element I have drawn here. As I am taking a depth b inside the paper, this is inside the paper b, and I have taken at this point the local velocity is u. Now this is the fluid flow traveled through this area. As depth b is inside, it means through this area, right? Now I will calculate the mass flow rate through this area. As we know that mass flow rate is equal to rho a v, right? For our case, area is dy into b, and v is local velocity u. This mass flow rate is for the small area when object is placed in a fluid. If I removed this object from the fluid and I want to calculate the mass flow rate for the same area at the same point, then it will be different, because this object creates velocity variation. But when there is no object, then the all particle velocity is the same, that is u infinity, right? So the mass flow rate for the same area when object is removed will be rho, area will be the same, dy into b, only the velocity changes, u infinity. Take this equation as a 2. U infinity is greater than u. Means at a point there is a reduction in mass flow rate when object is placed in a fluid. The difference between these mass flow rates is the reduction of mass flow rate at this point. This can be calculated by taking the difference between these two equations, 1 and 2. into dy into b is the same into u infinity minus u. This much of mass flow rate is less at this point when object is placed. Where the remaining mass flow rate is going? To compensate this reduction of mass flow rate at this point, the boundary layer displaces in y direction and this remaining mass flow rate is flowing over the boundary region. And this extra displacement of boundary layer is called as displacement thickness in boundary layer. It is denoted by del star, and this mass flowing over this boundary layer with the velocity u infinity. So this is increased boundary layer. This reduction in mass flow rate is for this elemental volume. Then what about this whole region? Calculate the reduction in mass flow rate over this all region by moving this strip along the y-axis. It means taking integration over 0 to del. Overall mass reduction is mass flow reduction is integration 0 to del overall mass reduction is equal to this portion, right? If this object was not there, then the flow will be like that. So this much reduction is there and this much mass is flowing in this region, right? It means the area of the both the region is same. So mass flow rate of this region and this region should be same. So take this as a 4. Now I will calculate the mass flow rate for this region. It will be del star into P, because this is del star and inside depth B which is in paper. This is area into rho into velocity is equal to u infinity of this region. The equation 4 and 5 are the same because how much reducted is flowing over the boundary layer. That's why both are equal. Del star into B into rho into u infinity is equal to 0 to del. Integration 0 to del rho into B into dy into u infinity minus u. Now b get cancelled, rho get cancelled, take this u infinity to this side, then del star is equal to integration 0 to del u infinity minus u upon u infinity into dy. That is nothing but 0 to del 1 minus u upon u infinity into dy. This is the expression for displacement thickness in boundary layer. You understood the video. If you have any doubts, please write in a comment. We'll meet you in the next video. Please like the videos and subscribe my channel for such educational videos.